After nearly 5 years of fighting in Iraq and Syria, the Trump administration signaled today that ISIS no longer controls any territory in either country. The brutal final battle has taken place in eastern Syria, in Baghouz, near Iraq's border. But this is not nearly the end of ISIS. Special correspondent Jane Ferguson is on the ground in Syria for the NewsHour.
Nighttime barrages marked the final days of the Islamic State. U.S.-backed Syrian Democratic Forces, or SDF, rained heavy gunfire down on ISIS after dark. As American and coalition airstrikes hit targets below, the attacks caused the encampment to catch fire. Stopping briefly to reload, the troops prepared for the next onslaught.
Every night, these troops come onto this small hilltop and hammer the ISIS positions just below, just behind us. So far, ISIS continue to hold out despite the onslaught.
In the day, ISIS can see again, and reaching the front line is more risky. Down below, on the edge of Baghouz village, the dying caliphate, a desperate patch of churned up land and abandoned trucks. Thousands of lives have been lost reaching this small, muddy patch by the River Euphrates.
It has taken over 4 years and an international coalition to back ISIS into this tiny corner just over this berm. But even now, they're having to show some restraint because all around in the area, they know there will be civilians embedded in there with ISIS.
Nearby, snipers picked off fighters who popped up from the tunnels and trenches ISIS had dug. This SDF soldier, called Reynas, told us he believed there were still several thousand ISIS loyalists down there. There are still women there, he told us. There are female fighters, around 50. In recent weeks, tens of thousands of ISIS members, men, women, and children, as well as their Yazidi captives, have surrendered and streamed out of the stronghold. Many sick and exhausted. Dozens of children died on the miserable march before making it to the trucks that take them to refugee camps.
We left Iraq because of the airstrikes and artillery bombing. We came to Syria and the same thing happened to us.
For the victors, the final defeat of ISIS marks the end of a long and bloody campaign. Today, the White House said the ISIS caliphate had lost all its territory.
Well, there's ISIS, and that's what we have right now, as of last night. That's what we have right now.
On Friday, fighting continued in Baghouz, as some ISIS fighters remain. This is the end for the ISIS dream of its own state, stretching across the Middle East and North Africa. But this is far from the end of ISIS. Syrian Democratic Forces spokesman Mustafa Bali reminded us that ISIS are still present, but hidden.
ISIS sleeper cells are active every day. The ISIS ideology is still very strong. It's not over.
This is a milestone, but it's not the end of ISIS.
Analyst Hassan Hassan of George Washington University has watched the Syria war from its earliest days and the rise and fall of the Islamic State.
You're no longer facing a physical ISIS, now you're facing a nebulous ISIS where you have to follow an entirely different approach in fighting them. So it's no longer sort of a military challenge primarily, it's more like a security challenge. And, you have to go and try to find out the sleeper cells, the sympathizers, the support network that they have in Iraq, Syria, and even beyond that.
Senior American military officials tell the NewsHour that the sheer numbers that came from Baghouz surprised U.S. forces, and that the level of strong, unrepentant ideological commitment to ISIS represents a longer-term threat.
I do not regret joining Islamic State. If my husband hadn't insisted for the kids, I wouldn't have come out. He insisted so he can get treatment. It's the same death. If I die here or in Baghouz.
The ideology itself will continue to exist. They are, because it never didn't start with ISIS, it predated ISIS and will continue to exist after ISIS. The conditions that existed because of the fight against ISIS have now worsened compared to what they used to be before ISIS.
ISIS fighters are still believed to be in the area surrounding Baghouz, hiding. Even the Syrian fighters on the battlefield don't like to drive through here. Roadside bombings began months ago. The group's evolution from army to insurgency continues. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jane Ferguson in Baghouz, eastern Syria.